Well, there's also new fallout today on Capitol Hill following a confrontation between Attorney General Eric Holder and two Republican congressmen. The Attorney General reacting passionately to allegations that the Department of Justice is enforcing voter rights laws, certain voter rights laws, based on race and not on merit. Shannon Bream is live in Washington with more on, we saw snippets of this yesterday, Shannon, but it got very heated and the Attorney General got pretty heated.
He did, and we watched that play out yesterday. These remarks from him, really the first public discussion, Megan, that we've seen from him about the Black Panther case and how it was handled by the Department of Justice. A number of lawmakers, as you said, pushed Holder. They said they still have a lot more questions than they do answers about that case. Take a listen to Republican Congressman John Culberson and then the Attorney General's response.
There's a lot of conflict between the official position of the Attorney General and the department and the sworn testimony of attorneys who work in the Civil Rights Division, and we've got sworn testimony that there's a pattern of behavior of refusing to enforce the law in a race-neutral manner.
When you compare what people endured in the South in the 60s to try to get the right to vote for African Americans, and to compare what people were subjected to there, to what happened in Philadelphia, which is inappropriate, certainly that, but to call that, to describe it in those terms, I think does a great disservice to people who put their lives on the line, who risked all for my people.
All right, of course, the reference to Philadelphia comes from this. The images are well known by now. Men standing outside a polling place in a manner that many people would view as threatening. Author Bartle Bull was a witness. Congressman Culberson cited Bull's testimony about what happened that day to the Attorney General, which he did not like. Take a listen to Bull in his own words.
Never have I seen a man standing in a militaristic uniform holding a weapon, in this case a large billy club, blocking the entrance to a polling place.
All right. The Attorney General did not like the comparison between that case and the battle in the South for African Americans to get their vote. He seemed very frustrated under that questioning yesterday, but it might not be over because in that same hearing, Congressman Culberson said he wants another separate congressional hearing on the Black Panther case and exactly how the DOJ is operating when it comes to civil rights and enforcing them. Megan?
Yeah, the Attorney General didn't seem to like Bartle Bull's comparison, but we should point out in Bartle Bull's defense, he is somebody who was recognized by the president for his civil rights work under RFK. He received a medal. He's spent his life basically defending civil rights, in particular for African Americans, and he was saying that this also was an egregious incident where both, he said, whites were prevented from voting or objected to voter intimidation, at least, and also testified, Shannon, to the fact that one black poll watcher who was there at that polling station that day was near tears. There was testimony that day that man was near tears because he also had been threatened. There were threats against blacks and whites alike, according to those who were there.
Bartle Bull is not your average witness or bystander in this case.
He's not. I mean, he's obviously a white guy, and he testified in a way that wasn't particularly helpful for the Department of Justice, but he has devoted his life to advocating on behalf of African Americans and making sure they have equal and civil rights. Shannon Bream, thank you.